Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can send data from a form in React to your Laravel backend using Inertia JS. In the previous episode, I showed you how to create pages in React, how to set up routing in Laravel, and then use Inertia JS to send information from your backend to React frontend. And I'll leave a link in the description to that video if you haven't seen it yet. Okay, so let's jump in and look at our form. I've set up a basic three-field form, which would normally represent a user registration. For instance, a name, an email, and a password. Okay, so if we click register without filling out the form, we should see some validation errors like this. Now we can go ahead and complete the form at email.com. And we just make a super simple password and we click register. And we get a simple thank you page after registration. Okay, so let's look at the code to see how this form has been wired up. Okay, so if we look at our routes file, we've got three simple routes. We've got a get route to the register endpoint that maps to the create method in the register controller. Then we've got a post method to the same register endpoint, which maps to the store method of the register controller. And then a simple get method to the thank you endpoint, which just basically renders the Inertia thank you page. Okay, and if we look at our register controller, we can see the create method returns the Inertia render method with our auth register form. Okay, so let's look at our store method next. Now it receives a custom form request, which we'll look in a second. Then it creates the user using the validated fields from that request. Then it returns a redirect to the thank you route, which then renders the thank you page you can see on the screen right now. And if we quickly look at our register request, we can see that it requires the name, the email, and the password with certain validation rules. Okay, and that basically covers the Laravel setup for this form. So let's go ahead and look at the React side of things. All right, now with regards to the React side of things, I created a register.tsx file, which is going to be our page. I created in the auth folder, which sits inside the pages folder. Now again, if you're unsure why we follow this folder structure, please check out the description for the link to the video where I explain how to create pages in React using Inertia. Okay, so our register page is a basic React functional component. We've got a form state to keep the values of the fields we submit. We also have this use page hook that is provided by Inertia, and we can use that to destructure the validation errors that we receive once we submit this form to the Laravel backend. We also have a handle change function, which we've hooked up to the input fields on the form to the onChange event. Now it receives the event details and then set the form state according to the key and the value. And our last function is the handle submit function, which we've linked up to the form on the onSubmit event. Now in our handle submit function, we receive the event and then we call the prevent default. This is to stop the form from refreshing the page once it is submitted. All right, so the last thing we do in our handle submit method is posting our data to our register endpoint. And we do this by calling the inertia.post method, first parameter supplying the route, and the second parameter would be our information, which in our case is our form state. Okay, so the last thing I want to show you is how to access or show the validation errors. As mentioned earlier, you can access the errors variable by destructuring it out of the use page hook supplied by Inertia, and then simply access it via the field name like this. Errors.name, errors.email, and errors.password. All right, so let's test out this form one last time to make sure everything is still working. All our field validation is working. And then we just fill out the fields and password. And we can see this email is already taken. So we just make it a new one. Register, and thank you for registering. And that's it for this episode, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.